bookshelf door, kind of, and then like book noises. So, book tapping. Like rubbing the books depending on the cover, like texture and stuff. I can attempt to like read a few things, but it's not gonna be pretty because I'm not really good at reading aloud. Anyway, so we're just gonna start off with the book that I'm reading right now, which is by, oh, I'm gonna butcher this name, Christelle Dabos. I'm not good with names, pronunciations. I suck at them, so I apologize if that's not how you pronounce the name. But this is my current read. I'm pretty sure I got this book because I like the cover. It was pretty. I buy books because of their covers. I know, not the best, but that's just how I get a lot of my books, because if the cover looks pretty, I'm like, the book has to be good, right? Sometimes it's not the case, but usually they're pretty good, and this book is really good. I'll read what it's about, and I apologize if I like mispronounce some names, some like words, because I'm not good at reading aloud. Also, literally, don't mind my hair. She's a mess. It's fine. Ophelia possesses two special gifts: a talent for seeing into an object's past, and the ability to travel through mirrors. It's pretty fucking cool. Her peaceful existence on Anima is interrupted when she is promised in marriage to the doctor. A member of a powerful clan from a cold and distant arc. A pawn in a dangerous game that will have far-reaching consequences for her entire world. Ophelia must navigate the lies and machinations, oh god, I definitely butchered that one, of her fiancé's clan in order to survive. In this first installment of the internationally best-selling Mirror Visitor series. It's a pretty good book. I'm on page such a good book. I would recommend reading this. It's like a fantasy romance series. So another series that I have in here. A Court of Thorn and Roses. My favorite series, or like kind of like my favorite series now. It's not my favorite series of all time. It's like tied with another series. Oh, it's so hard to like be there. I'm also sorry if I literally look disgusting. My hair's a little crazy and like my veins, because I tuck them behind my ear all the time, they usually get crunchy or like kinky. I don't know what word to use for that. I'm just gonna turn to a random page and I'll read like a paragraph. Section or like a page from the front of the book, so it's not like a spoiler or anything. I didn't give myself a chance to panic, to doubt, to do anything but wish I had stolen some food from my bed and breakfast table as I layered on tunic after tunic and bundled myself in a cloak, stuffing the knife I'd stolen into my boot, the extra gloves in the satchel. On this part of the bookshelf, along with like, so I haven't read this series or this book, which is Six of Crows. I've heard it's really good, but it's mentioned that you should read the Shadow of Bone series before you read the Six of Crows series. So, or Six of Crows, not Six of Crows. Dance of Thieves is a really series. I very much liked it. It's a very good book. I recommend highly. I'll read them back to you. And I'm gonna butcher words on this page because like fantasy books, they have like big words in them and I'm just dumb. Okay. A formidable outlaw family that claims to be the first among the nations. A son destined suddenly into power. Three fierce young women of the Raton, the Queen's premier guard. I think I said that word right. Premier. A legendary street thief leading a mission determined to prove herself. Legendary. Her nickname is Ten. I distinctly remember that because she. Some thieves. like quotes from other people, like who've read the book. This is one of those quotes. A brilliant fantasy with a bold beauty. With a boldly beating heart. Mary E. Pearson, who is the author of this book, is a fearless storyteller. I'm still trying to catch back breath. I was very shocked when I found out that they literally are living with their parents' murderer. Like, that's insane. What? Main character's name is Jude. I've seen like TikToks of edits of her and spoiler. Oh, what was his name? Garden. I've seen TikToks of those two and they're like, they're so cute. pants. Sorry. To live in a palace and compete for the heart of a gorgeous Prince Maxon. Prince Maxon. Prince Maxon. But for America, a singer, being selected is a nightmare. It means turning her back on her secret love, Aspen, who is a guest below her, and leaving her home. Competition for a crown she doesn't want. Then America meets Prince Guest. I'm getting mixing my books up. Gradually, she begins to realize that the life she's always dreamed of may not compare to a future she never imagined. still don't have a microphone. I probably won't have one for like the longest time, and I'm just gonna be using my phone for the video because I'm a college student. So yeah, but I really do appreciate you guys watching and liking the videos and even commenting, or the people that do comment, because like obviously this is like just the start of my YouTube channel. So, but I appreciate. This just for fun. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it.